हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड इवनिंग, वेलकम टू माय पॉडकास्ट W5, वाव वुमन विनिंग वंडरफुल वर्ल्ड। गुलजार साहब ने क्या खूब कहा है, कुछ अलग करना हो तो भीड़ से हटके चलिए, भीड़ साहस तो देती है मगर पहचान छीन लेती है। दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव सीन ऑल दीज वाव वुमन्स हैव सेट देयर फुटप्रिंट, लाइक मैं चलती रही और कारवा बनता गया। सो टुडे वी विल सी द स्टोरी ऑफ फर्स्ट इंडियन वुमन टू सेट फुट ऑन एंटार्क्टिका, सुदीप्ता सेनगुप्ता, हु कम्स फ्रॉम लैंड ऑफ दुर्गा। एंड वंस शी सेड, एज अ चाइल्ड आई बिलीव दैट दुर्गा लिव्ड इन कैलाश, बट नाउ आई नो दैट दुर्गा लिव्स इन अस, इन ऑल वुमन। सुदीप्ता द यंगेस्ट डॉटर अमंगस्ट थ्री वॉज बॉर्न टू ज्योति रंजन सेनगुप्ता एंड पुष्पा सेनगुप्ता in Calcutta, India. Her father was a meteorologist and that's why her family spent a lot of time in both India and Nepal. Sudipta graduated from Jadavpur University with top honors in both BSc and MSc examination. She was awarded PhD in 1972 for her work under the supervision of Dr. Subir Kumar Ghosh. She started her professional career as a geologist in the Geological Survey of India between 1970 and 1973. In 1973, she received the prestigious scholarship of Royal Commission for Exhibition from UK and carried out postdoctoral research work for next 3 years at Imperial College, London. In 1977, she joined the Institute of Geology of Uppsala University, Sweden as a docent for 6 months and thereafter carried out research as a visiting scientist in connection with the International Geodynamics Project, which was supervised by Professor Hans Ramberg. Thereafter, returning to India in 1979, she joined the Geological Survey of India as senior geologist. In 1982, she joined Jadavpur University as lecturer and retired as professor. So all this sequence of graduation, doctorate, postdoctorate reflects her passion and love for education. Because when we see a rising graph or a rising star, we only see its shine. But the story of Dhruv Tara should be remembered at these instances, which is known to all of us, I assume. And thus, we know Dhruv shined after undergoing lot of hardship. He was thrown, fried and whatnot, and ultimately, star shined in the sky. So similarly, all these wow women shine after facing many ups and downs, but they didn't lose their patience, maintain their hardship and consistency, only steps of ladder to success. Once Sudipta ma'am said, for the first 15 years of my life, there were hardly any women in the class. In most of the years, none. She talks about the fact that university were not prepared to accommodate women during field trips. Conditions didn't improve until 1996, she says. She says, at that time, it was terrible. They had to stay in dharmshalas and sometimes huts. But she adds the fact, in some way, it was better in her days. She went on for her PhD studies alone, traveled to remote places with bad roads, no communication, but never felt unsafe. But these days, she says, she would not dare to send a girl alone for fieldwork. Sudipta was trained in advanced mountaineering by first men to scale Mount Everest in 1953, Mr. Tenzing Norgay. And so, she is an expert mountaineer. She has participated in numerous mountaineering expeditions in India and Europe, including an unnamed virgin peak in Lahore region, which was later famous as Mount Lalona. Sudipta says, her field work taught her a lot. An important lesson she learned is, people are same everywhere. They are basically good and helpful. What a good lesson. Even if to see an Indian girl moving around with a hammer was very new for them, yet they supported. In 1983, Sudipta Sengupta was selected as a member, third Indian expedition to Antarctica, and conducted pioneering geological studies in Skarmacker Hills of East Antarctica. She became first woman scientist from India to take part in Antarctica expedition with Aditi Pant, a marine biologist. In 1989, she visited Antarctica for the second time as a member of 9th expedition to Antarctica. Her work is of fundamental importance as it became the basis of further research in that area. In the major part of her research in structural geology, she has combined geological field studies with laboratory experiment and theoretical analysis. She talks about her experience in Antarctica, mentioning geology prejudices extend to that land as well. Antarctica was also a male Boston. Women scientists were not allowed there before 1956. She remembers men joking that a woman could not go without a beauty parlor in Antarctica. In 1982, she applied to join an Indian expedition to Antarctica. But being a woman, her application was rejected first. But her consistent persuasion brought her victory, and she was later taken in expedition of 1982 and 1989 also. On both expeditions, she traveled on ship, taking a month to get there. Once they were on land, the crew had to work on blizzard and a sun that never set. In the days when she went to Antarctica, India had only one base station, Dakshin Gangotri, which now is not in function and is fully submerged in ice. The Maitri station was already up and running by then in Skarmacker Oasis in East Antarctica and is still an active research base. She has published papers in national and international journals. She is author of one of the bestseller book in Bengali, Antarctica. She is a fellow of Indian National Science Academy. Government of India awarded her Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize for Science and Technology, one of the highest Indian science award, for her contribution to Earth, Atmosphere, Ocean and Planetary Science in 1991. She is also recipient of National Mineral Award and Antarctica Award. Friends, Sudipta was geologist during 80s, a time when women were discouraged for taking part in any field work. But then, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Jo khairat mein milti kamyabi, to har shakhs kamyab hota. Jo khairat mein milti kamyabi, to har shakhs kamyab hota. Phir qadar na hoti kisi hunar ki, aur na hi koi shakhs lajawab hota, na hi koi shakhs lajawab hota. So here we come to the end of journey of first woman to step on Antarctica. Meet you tomorrow with new start of a wow woman tomorrow. Till then, keep smiling, be happy, bye-bye.